As the Gunawage Education Center prepares for another school year, some of their key administrators reflect on what challenges they faced during the last few months dealing with COVID-19. Director of Education Robin Delarone said several things were still a top priority.
Collaboration was really some of the things that I have to say was a challenge. And, you know, that limited our ability to, or in my perception, the ability to really finalize things, because we were trying to do two things. One is obviously finalize your year in terms of the normal operations that go on, but you're also, we were trying to finalize the year in terms of the pandemic, looking back at the year, what happened, but right away making plans for the upcoming year. So there was a bit of a multitude of things all in a year end.
Delarone says the KEC faced challenges as a team.
It was reassuring everyone that this is new. We're all in this together. This is our new reality. We have to do the best that we can do with what we have. And it was that times when we were all able to share some of the concerns and so forth. So for me personally, that was how I was able to overcome some of the challenges, was through that communication, but also through strong teamwork, where everyone knew what we were in, what we were was involved, and supporting one another.
They developed innovative approaches to keep the lines of communication open, says Gattaruni Stacy, curriculum team coordinator.
At that time, it was decided that we would develop a weekly newsletter. So the curriculum team pulled together and we decided to call it a Spotlight on Learning. So the goal of the newsletter at the time was to support families at home to continue their learning. So we knew it would be a challenging time, and there was a lot of unknowns about what was going to be happening. So we wanted to offer tools and different resources for families to be able to log into and to continue at their own pace without having pressures of having to follow a curriculum for parents at that time. So resulting from that was this review and an analysis of all these online resources and programs. So we were able to determine what would work best, what things were free, what would be most accessible and engaging for students and families. So that was a real huge learning curve, I guess, for the curriculum team, but an opportunity to really see everything that was out there and think about how we would use it in our classrooms, not only during the pandemic, but beyond.
Aside from student and family support, the KEC wanted to ensure they would continue to meet the needs of their teaching staff.
So through all that work in developing and preparing for the weekly Spotlight on Learning newsletter, we were able to, at the same time, identify the different professional development that would be needed to support our teachers in transitioning to online learning. We took the time over the past few months to see what was out there and really determine a strong plan for when students do return. So we'll be ready and teachers and all staff will be prepared for whatever is decided on how the mode of education that will take place, if it's blended learning, if it's primarily online. So as that develops, no matter what the situation, we'll be able to be prepared for this return of the students in the new school year.
When the pandemic hit, Gunawage schools went into a state of emergency mode and adapted quickly. Principals at each of the community schools implemented guidelines set by the Gunawage Emergency Task Force.
We immediately went into emergency mode where all teachers were off, all admin, all staff was off. And so from there, what we had to do is learn how to adapt quickly, because even though we weren't physically at work, there was a lot of planning and things that had to be done in order to prepare for next year. So one thing that I did for our school is that I created a group chat just to keep all of our teachers and staff in the loop with all of the current information. Then eventually we all had Zoom accounts to where we had to do our regular staff meetings, but online. As for the teachers, there's a lot of end of the year things that go on after the kids leave behind the scenes. So for a few days in June, when it was deemed safe that we were able to go in again, we practiced social distancing and had a staggered schedule for the teachers, and they were like able to go in. They completed their report cards without giving marks, and they were able to just finish up their tasks at the school.
But we knew we had to look at what we could do to service the students and also to see what types of PD we were going to need to adapt to the more online way of teaching. Tim LaHash came and joined us in a Zoom meeting, which we did many of, to help teachers learn a little bit more about Google Classroom.
We knew that we were not going back into the school, so we started Google training and Zoom training for the teachers and the teaching assistants, because we knew we had to reach out to the students some way, because we couldn't have that contact more or less with them. And we were really worried about the grade 10s and 11s, because you know, grade 10s and 11s are applying, their credits are really important for going to CGIPS and everything else. And we want to make sure the gaps were more or less bridged, so that when they were going up to CGIP that they were prepared. So some of the teachers did online classes, voluntary classes to the students. We also did do online mandatory courses for all the kids that need those marks. So in order to do this, of course in Gunawaga, we do have a lot of parents that do not have technology. So at school we had Chromebooks. So we lent out the Chromebooks to the parents and it started rolling out. And mostly it was just for the grade 10s and 11s. For the course subjects like French, science, social studies, language arts, and math. We have a few classes of special needs classrooms, so the teachers reach out to those kids especially because they don't understand the concept of not coming into the building. So we just like, they set up just little Zoom chats and everything else going on, you know, going online and everything else. And we usually have a summer school where the kids, like they didn't make the mark in 50s, they would go to summer school at KSS, but because of the pandemic, they could not come into the school. And we realized during this time, parents weren't getting paid, that we would offer a free summer school program online for the grade 7, 8, and 9, and some of the grade 10 students. So that rolled out in early June. We went for 2 weeks with it. We're not realizing as educators that some kids that have anxiety or stress but coming into a building, some of this online platform really worked for them and they feel more comfortable, and you could see the progress that they made when they were online.
With the ongoing pandemic, planning and strategy for the new school year is key.
So the curriculum team is excited for the new upcoming new school year. We're of course continuing to align all disciplines within the Dinyin Warihoda program. We're continuing to review and strengthen the essential learning outcomes for all disciplines. And of course, we're aiming for an integrated curriculum, and we're also developing multidisciplinary units and using the mode of the PBL, which is project-based learning. So that's, of course, it's not something new to the KEC and to our schools. However, we're still working towards strengthening that, and as we've seen it to be a very successful mode of delivering curriculum in that approach. So it's really hands-on, multidisciplinary for our students. We're also going to be embarking on a lot of exciting projects, specifically I can mention Ganyat Geha. We're going to have a new program that we're going to be working on. We'll be developing new resources for Ganyat Geha, and of course continuing to strengthen the program from nursery all the way to grade 11.
The plan for reopening the doors to Gahnawage schools this fall encompasses the health, safety and well-being of both students and staff.
We are making plans in terms of our school, how to open the doors to our students, making sure that we have spaces for them to work in the school where they will be respecting the distancing or the hygiene and making sure that they are safe. So we're working on that right now and all type of scenarios. So we have at least 2 to 3 type of scenarios that we're planning for.
The KEC says they do have a plan B.
In the event that we are not allowed to go back to the school and it's deemed unsafe, we are preparing to fully go online with our learning. So that is going to be a challenge, we know, for Greater Unionville School because it is a Mohawk immersion. And what you find out there for the other schools is that teachers are able to go on Google Classroom or Khan Academy or access different apps and give them to their students, where because our school is a Mohawk immersion language setting, we're not able to access all of that technology in the language. So what we're working on is working with the curriculum center at our school to try to get the materials online in time for September, and also to be able to make physical packages for all of the students in the event that we have to go online. So what it would look like is that teachers are teaching to them to their classes, but all of the students have their physical materials at home so that we wouldn't have to put so much online and create all of these resources. So we want to use what we already have and plan it that way.
The KEC, along with other key community organizations, are working together, ensuring that the best interests of Kahnawake students are at the forefront of any plan.
We also know that we have to have collaboration and plans with external orgs such as the Town Garage and MCK, because those are some meetings we also have to have over the summer with them. Once we know what are some scenarios we anticipate, we're going to be collaborating with them to say, how can you support us with these plans in terms of transportation and so forth. We're going to be working really hard come mid-July, right into August, to make sure parents are going to be informed near end of July or probably the beginning of August of what our plans are.